Welcome to the Vantage HR Influencers Podcast. This podcast is sponsored by Vantage Circle, the leading employee benefits and engagement platform.
Hi, everyone. This is Sushmita from Vantage HR Influencer Podcast. Well, today we are going to start with a very interesting topic on employee engagement because we have with us a very experienced learning facilitator, a motivational speaker, and a digital learning content creator, Deepika Singh. Welcome to the show, Deepika.
Thank you so much, Sushmita. I'm so glad to be on the show. I've heard your earlier podcast as well, and I must say, very, very interesting. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Yeah. So before we start, let us know a little more about you and your journey as a content creator.
Sure. So I have been working as an experiential learning facilitator for quite a few years now. I was in marketing earlier. Okay. And for the last about 7-8 years, this is what I've been doing. And somewhere along the way, I also started creating content around this subject. So while I do a lot of work and a lot of motivational speaking at corporates, I also realized that, you know, I like creating content, and content, especially video content, is the future.
Okay, yeah.
So around 2 years back, I started creating content and around the same subjects that I work, which is experiential learning and motivation. Mm-hmm. And now I also create content around those same subjects.
Okay. So the topic that we're going to discuss today is how to boost employee engagement through content. So what, according to you, is meant by content when it comes to employee engagement?
Okay, so you know how you engage with your employees through text or through apps or through videos or any kind of, you know, challenges, for example. So everything which is not offline but is actually virtual. Okay. In the form of either text or in the form of video or in the form of challenges, in the form of audio, perhaps. Mm-hmm. You know, that is what I would call content, you know. Okay. And it doesn't necessarily have to be only one-way communication. It could also be two-way communication. So for example, let's say in your own case, like you have Vantage Fit, right?
Yeah.
You can actually do these challenges through an app, for example, or
yes,
just
we have
some
an
kind
app.
Of video. Yeah. In videos. Yeah, so posting videos, you know, about fitness, etc. So any content that you can use to get your employees to learn something new or, you know, interact with each other, interact with peers, interact with seniors, right. You know, get to know more about the processes of the, you know, the organization, or just simply have fun. Mm-hmm. That I would, you know, employee engagement content.
Okay. So according to you, what are the most popular types or forms of content for employee engagement?
So, you know, if you treat, you know, if you just look at content per se, you know, if for some time we remove ourselves from the whole corporate and employee engagement structure, and we just look at content per se, you'll see that most people do prefer video form of content nowadays, right? And people also prefer content which is, you know, short form
right.
content.
Right. Yeah.
So having said that, if you just look outside and look at your employees just as people, that's the kind of content they like. Content which is also fun, puzzles, challenges. Right. So if I were to apply that to within corporates, then yes, it would be video. It would be maybe short form write-ups also, text also, but I think video, just simple forwards like WhatsApp forwards that you get, image for you know, forwards, interesting videos, that would be the content that would also apply to employee engagement, right? So any kind of content that is interesting just outside also, it's the same content that your people will like as far as employee engagement is also concerned, right? Yeah. So I would say video, and I would say very short form text.
So what are the best ways to disseminate these contents?
There are various forms of dissemination of content nowadays. So for example, a lot of organizations now have internal portals, right? And you can make those internal websites or internal portals very, very interesting. Okay. Of course, newsletters, emails are a great way of disseminating information. Nowadays, every organization also has WhatsApp groups. Teams have WhatsApp groups, right? So that's another great way of disseminating, you know, content. Apps. You know, internal apps, internal community people have. I know a lot of organizations that are using, let's say, for example, Workplace or, you know, so just social channels, which are social media, which is internal, right? Employee engagement. So a lot of people are using all forms of channels now to engage in content with their employees.
Yeah. As you already know that we have our own product named Vantage Fit. So our team members would like to know how contents can be used around fitness.
Oh, you can do so much around fitness. For example, you know, challenges, getting people to post videos of their fitness, you know, exercises that they're doing. Maybe do like a little home workout challenge. I know that, you know, we've all been in lockdown for so long now.
Right.
So you can also do how many calories burnt, or you can actually do creative ways of, you know, staying fit in the house. So you can actually run a little challenge saying creative ways of staying fit in the house. Mm-hmm. What are you doing to stay fit? You can actually do so many interesting things to just engage. I also feel that, you know, fitness is very big right now. And I feel a lot of people take on fitness by their own selves. I think organizations can also do a lot to ensure that their employees stay fitter, right? And when you have challenges and when you have team challenges, challenges and competitions happening, people just feel more, especially around fitness, people feel more, you know, they want to participate. So you can actually do a lot with fitness, around fitness. You can actually also disseminate a lot of information around fitness. You know, there is so much, in spite of so much information which is available, there is still a lot of confusion in the minds of people around workouts, fitness. You can do daily workouts, for example. You can send out daily workout of the day, you know, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, just that much workout of the day you can send out. People can send photographs or post photographs. Mm-hmm. So actually a lot to do with fitness.
Okay. So considering the current situation, a lot of people are working from home. How can HR make use of content to keep remote workers engaged?
It's a tricky situation now because, you know, earlier what happened was that people are meeting each other. And, you know, there's so much interaction. But now your workers are remote. So you really don't know. While it's a great thing, and I think all of us are coping really well, but it's still important to have a certain sense of engagement and a certain sense of bonding, even when you're, you know, working remote. Especially in a situation right now where there's a lot of anxiety. Some people are going through some anxiety problems. And so I think there's a thing you can do. You know, you can have so much information that you can. So for example, it's a great time to really think out of the box, you know. For a client of ours, he said that, you know, why don't we do, for your senior management, why don't we do short interviews, you know, about their journey? Because what happens is it's a great way to get to know people right now, but in a very different manner, right? We all, so can we do like little, like we do interviews, there's so many webinars that are happening. Can we do interviews with your senior managers about their journey, interesting life perspectives, life lessons, and then distribute it within their employees, right? So it doesn't necessarily have to be just, you know, a team bonding exercise or just, you know, it can be so many interesting things. So a lot of new people are now joining you know, organizations during this particular period. So what do you do to ensure that those people know about your organization, about the culture, the processes? You can actually do it through very interesting content. So can you send out a daily newsletter or mailer to somebody who's joining with an interesting thing about your culture, you know, interesting, you know, content about your culture of the organization? Can you introduce the people through a little video or through a little, you know, this thing? Can you introduce the senior management? Can there be like a 2-minute video taken from the senior management, and can that go out to all the new joinees? So you'll just have to think out of the box, the content that you will have to create to engage with people right now.
Yeah. So I guess videos can really motivate people. Like in case of fitness too, many employees don't take up the challenges. So motivating them through the through some creative videos can be really a good option.
Absolutely. Right?
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. Totally agree.
So we can understand that contents create a mutual sense of belongingness. So is it like only the HRs and the team leaders are responsible to bring this feeling?
No, I think, you know, it can be, right now, I think it's a great time to think out of the box. So anyone can really, be, you know, coming up with ideas. I think, for example, marketing. Why I say marketing is because marketing is used to interacting with remote customers. So if you look at marketing's job, and this, I was also reading a brilliant article on LinkedIn the other day, and it made me think. And I thought that, you know, marketing's job is to reach out and engage with people that are anywhere. Customers can be anywhere. You don't know customers, right? Your customers are remote. Your customers could be anywhere. So marketing has always been thinking
along those lines of how do you reach out to people who are somewhere. Right. Similarly, marketing, because of their experience, would know how to reach out to employees that are now no longer in front of you, you know. Mm-hmm. So what are the, so the same principles of marketing can be used to actually reach out to employees as well. But having said that, anyone can be, you, this time, I think it's such a new normal that anything can be tried right now, honestly speaking, you know. So you really have to think out of the box. And it's not just the duty of the HR. While HR can drive something like this, yes, definitely. And team leaders also will have to drive it because, you know, it is their teams. They have to stay bonded with their teams. They have to ensure that people are, you know, constantly in touch with each other. And they have to understand, there has to be a lot of empathy. But having said that, anyone can drive content projects or employee engagement projects right now.
So how can I measure the effectiveness of these contents, or say what are its tracking metrics?
So, you know, for all content, so I would divide content into two. One is content that you disseminate only so that you can stay in touch with the employee, right? The other is, you know, for example, learning content, right? So you can do a weekly, you know, you can do like a weekly session where you talk about all the a learning content that has been disseminated to you. But at the same time, you can also, so for example, courses, like if you look outside, courses have, you know, quizzes at the end of it, or they have, you know, what have you learned at the end of it. So there is a way of tracking, you know, what this person has done, right? So if you're, for example, if I take your case only, if I take fitness challenges, for example, there are so many ways of tracking what people have done with that fitness content. So let's say at the end of the week, you have to, that challenge, have you achieved other challenge, or do you want to post a video? So there are many ways of actually tracking this content.
Yeah. But in case of like newsletters or emails that we send to our employees, like employees who receive the emails don't even, they don't even care, or many don't even feel the need to reply back or anything, right? So in that case, how can the effectiveness be measured? Like, has the message of the email reached the employee in the correct sense?
So I, you know, I would look at more new age distribution systems. While I understand that, you know, for, especially for employee engagement, I would have to make it more relevant. I would have to make it more interesting.
Okay.
And I will, like I said, you know, when I, when we first started this podcast, I was talking about how you have to look outside. Does this guy, so emails intrinsically mean work. Matlab, it's a force thing, you know, emails. I look at very distribution, very different distribution channels for employee engagement content. The minute it is an email, now my mind will shut off. And, you know, I will think, acha, ek aur email HR se, ya ek aur email, you know. You will have to now think out of the box on how do you engage this guy. Like I said, you will have to look at new age distribution systems, whether it is a portal, even WhatsApp for that matter. And you will have to make it shorter and sharper. Every piece of content will have to be shorter. Like, you know, outside also, with 3 seconds, 4 seconds, 5 seconds, he scrolls past content which is not interesting. Your employee is applying the same principle to content which is coming from within the organization as well. So you will now have to start thinking like a marketing person and say that even HR, internal, you will have to start thinking like a marketing person that this is my customer, internal customer. How do I catch his interest? Are emails the right way? Perhaps not. Are apps the right way? Maybe. Are, is WhatsApp the right way? So there is a lot of thought that has to go into, you know, what is the distribution channel that you use for this content.
So as we can see, as I can see that you have created a lot of contents for a variety of professionals. So what are the basic things that you keep in mind while creating the scene?
So relevance, obviously. How relevant is it to the people, you know, that... so we work in two ways. We work on briefs. So, you know, for example, will come back to us and tell us that this is my brief. So for example, new joinees, for example. And unke liye we want to create a daily... let's say a video which is very short, at the same time very interesting around certain subjects. You know, it could be a process or it could be, so we'll create like a little animated video, you know, about the processes of the organization and who are the functional heads and who are the department heads and, you know, things like that, like a chart. So ek to brief ke upar hota hai, you know. Dusra is when you create content which is in any case going to be, you know, light. So let's say newsletters, we get inquiries for newsletters that we want to create like a monthly newsletter which is very interesting that should go out to all the employees, and we we create something, then we have sections, fitness hai, cookery hai, children, families hai, then we have a little game at the bottom. Sometimes we even do videos which are, motivational. So right now we've got a lot of requests for short 2-minute, 3-minute motivational videos that can just go out, and very simple motivation that can go out on WhatsApps to, organizations, to the entire teams, etc. So what we try and do is we try and keep it very relevant to the brief. We also try and understand what is the culture of the organization basis which. So what is the tone of the content? What is the kind of content will depend upon the culture of the organization. And then also we keep in mind attention spans of people, So all content is based, what is the attention span of people? It can't be too lengthy. Also depending on the subject. Sometimes if it's a learning based content, it has to be a certain way. If it is just engagement and fun, it has to be a certain way. But I think broadly, those are the things we keep in mind.
So would you like to give some tips to boost employee engagement through content to our listeners?
Oh, yes. Right now, there's a lot of digital in any case right now. Mm-hmm. People are stuck with their screens, and the only way people are interacting with each other is digitally. Mm-hmm. But I think you have to create a sense of belonging right now, because a lot of people may also be feeling, that whole sense of belonging that they have with each other, so that may be missing right now. So you can actually create content which is slightly more fun, slightly more motivational, but at the same time, interesting, to disseminate. I would stay away from more, webinars and more, but a lot of life skills can be taught, so a lot of short life skills. I would also create content for, let's say, children, so you'll have to think again out of the box and say that this person, my employee is at home. What is he needing right now? So do you want to create, so children are also going to go into summer holidays. So employee engagement, which also reaches out to families right now. So do you want to create like a daily puzzle for the children of the house, and send it out so that children are also busy. It's like a coloring thing that the children can do. Mm-hmm. So there's a whole lot of content that you can create right now and use it, because it's a very, very different time right now.
Yeah. Okay. Great.
Do you also want to do like a talent contest using video, for example? Mm-hmm. Everybody sends in their, singing or whoever wants to participate, and then a video is made and sent out to everybody. Mm-hmm. So you will have to do things that, sort of continue that feeling of belonging to the organization.
Okay. Right. So there are so many things more to learn and understand when it comes to creating contents for businesses and its people. So many of our listeners would like to reach out to you for more. So please share the best way that they can reach out to you.
I forgot to mention this earlier, but my brand is actually called She Means Business. I started this many years ago. The company is called Life Is More, but She Means Business is the name I go by, because I started this chat show a couple of years ago with women, to create more role models. Mm-hmm. But the best way to reach out to me really is, I have a website, shemeansbusiness.co. Mm-hmm. And my mail is very simple. It's info@shemeansbusiness.co. I also have a lovely, social media following and channels, Instagram and Facebook, both She Means Business by Deepika Singh. In fact, I do lives on my social media channels, motivational lives on my social media channels every day, which I've been doing very, very well. Okay. But in case you need content, and in case you need to, discuss content for employee engagement, I think the best way to do that would be to reach out to me on info@shemeansbusiness.co.
Okay, great. Well, Deepika, it was really great having you on our show. Thanks for connecting.
Thank you so much. I wish you all the best. I think you have a great app. And I also think fitness is very, very big right now. And it's a great way to get, teams to do interesting challenges and interesting things. Yeah. So I wish you all the best as well.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Susmita.
Thanks for listening to Vantage HR Influencers Podcast. Please do subscribe to Vantage HR Influencers Podcast on Apple Podcasts and Spotify for new episodes.